I want to say a very big, mighty thank you for your prayers during the past 1 week, which I was a bit under the weather and I just couldn't cope again with the emails. And I said, oh, I can't cope again. I need to rest. I need to take care of myself. And that was the last video I uploaded. A lot of you just kept pouring messages and emails. I am super grateful for everybody on this channel, everybody who subscribed to this channel. Thank you so much. Your prayers kept me strong and I am back. And I promise to be uploading videos from now on. And I hope I don't fall sick again. Thank you so much. So today's video is basically to talk about businesses in Canada. Not just businesses, but immigrants that actually come to Canada to establish business. One thing I have observed, having lived in Canada for like, this is my fourth year in Canada, is that there are a group of people who are very good at establishing businesses. And this group of people are taking advantage of their population. I won't use the word taking advantage, but there are more of them in Canada. That's why they are able to establish businesses that suits their communities. And apart from that, they've been able to sell some of their culture to, you know, a lot of people that are not part of their culture. Canada is a mosaic country, so you have a lot of people from different parts of the world immigrating to Canada. I'm sorry, this is not an immigration topic, but it's something I feel will be useful to anybody who watches it. So Canada is a mosaic country and you have a lot of people coming from various parts of the world. You have people from India, China, in fact from all parts of the world that you can think of. And based on that, there is a particular group of people whose population is more than some other group of people. And I find that Indians are more in Canada, the Filipinos are more in Canada, Chinese are more in Canada. The reason why I say immigrants are more in Canada is because of the kind of businesses that they establish, they are able to establish in Canada, and how they are able to bring in more immigrants into Canada based on their population. For the Indian immigrants, they have been able to establish businesses in the trucking industry. So you find most of the Indian immigrants who are truckers, and they have established trucking businesses in Canada, successful trucking businesses in Canada, and they're able to establish companies that are recruiting people from outside Canada to come and work as truckers in Canada. The Chinese also have established themselves in such a way that the real estate industry is one area where I know a lot of Chinese investors come to buy real estate properties in Canada. So real estate in Canada, you find that most of the owners, especially the Vancouver area, British Columbia, you find that most of them are owned by Chinese immigrants. And you have small industries in Canada as well, small shops like Chinese restaurants, spas, acupuncture, some Chinese herbal therapy medicine and stuff like that. They're able to establish all these small businesses, and even with their poor language skills, their poor English skills, they're able to establish most of these businesses in Canada. The Filipinos also have also established successful businesses, especially in the home childcare industry, home support worker industry, and the foreign temporary workers, people who work in the hospitality industries. Yeah, a lot of those smaller industries, the Filipinos have been able to carve a niche for themselves, and they're able to employ foreign temporary workers to come into Canada to work in these areas. I'm trying to bring out the fact that Africans are missing when it comes to establishing strong businesses. Africans are well known for academics. We are known for going to school, and that's what you find in Canada. You find most schools occupied by African students going to school. Of course, there are Indian students as well. There are Chinese students as well. There are Filipino students as well. But this group of people are also able to establish businesses, whereas Africans are not establishing businesses. Instead, we are more or less in the academic world. We are going to school to do MBAs, to get a PhD, do all sorts of degrees and certifications and all that. And whereas our counterparts are establishing businesses and are thriving in Canada. So this video is actually to encourage African immigrants that we should not just be focusing only on academics and packing degrees and certificates and all that. I mean, it's tiring to just focus on only academics and degrees and certificates when our counterparts are actually thriving in businesses. So this video is to encourage every immigrant, anybody planning to come to Canada, to think of a business to establish in Canada rather than being an employee and remaining an employee forever. So there are several businesses that you can establish in Canada. You can partner in some. You can actually buy a franchise depending on your pocket. I know most people are actually looking for money, so they will say, I don't have money to establish a business in Canada. It's quite expensive to establish a business in Canada. But there are actually several ways of establishing businesses, and that is looking for a business owner who wants to sell off his business, maybe because he's old and he doesn't have someone to inherit the business. There are several of them in Canada, and you find them in all of these smaller rural communities. So it is best to actually do your research and like all these rural and northern immigration pilot communities, you can search for those communities and you see businesses that you can buy. If you don't want to buy them outrightly, you can buy at least a 50% or 51% stake in those businesses and immigrate to Canada under work permit. After 1 year, you apply for a permanent resident status and you become a permanent resident as a business owner in Canada. So that option is actually available, and I am encouraging Africans to actually exploit this option. Let's not just be people who are about academics and degrees and having PhDs and professors, and we don't have anything in our pockets. I mean, we have the mindset of actually running businesses, and I believe that if we run businesses, we'll be able to use our influence as business owners to be able to bring in more immigrants into Canada. So so this is the information I actually want to share, and if you know anybody who is interested in establishing a business or buying of a business, you can actually tell the person to email me. I'll be able to search for business opportunities, profitable businesses, not just businesses, profitable businesses in Canada that is suitable for immigration. And instead of the person sinking in the express entry pool and thinking of what to do, the person can actually come to Canada as a part business owner or business operator owner and become a permanent resident. And I also want to share that Quebec has the cheapest investment amount for business establishment. So for somebody who is an entrepreneur or a self-employed person, and the person wants to establish his or her business in Quebec, as long as it is outside the municipality area of Montreal, I think it's in Montreal, I don't know. As long as it is outside, the amount to invest in such business is $25,000 Canadian, and then you should have a net worth of $100,000. Canadian dollars. But for every other provinces like Manitoba, Saskatchewan, New Brunswick, Nova Scotia, Prince Edward Island, you would have to have about $150,000 Canadian to invest, and then maybe $400,000 or $300,000 net worth. So this is the information I want to share today, and I hope that it is useful to somebody. I will also request that you click the thumbs up button or the like button for the sake of the YouTube algorithm. I think it's something I just learned recently, that YouTube algorithm actually responds to likes more than comments or whatever. But anyway, share this video to somebody who is planning to come and establish a business in Canada and expand his or her empire in Canada. I know that a lot of people would like to expand their empire in Canada or expand their business and have a business office in Canada as well. So if you know anybody who has the funds, who has the finance, and is willing to buy any business in Canada, tell the person to send me an email. I'll be able to link the person up with several communities where there are businesses up for sale and the person can look into that opportunity of immigrating as a business owner to Canada. Thank you so much for watching and see you in my next video. Bye bye.